The Global Assessment of Human-Induced Soil Degradation, GLASID. This project was one of the first attempts to assess the state of degradation of soil from a global perspective. The world map produced by GLASID showed the status of human-induced soil degradation and was based mainly on expert judgment and reported degrees of land degradation that also included the notion of resilience, which was deemed essential for land management decisions. Although the GLASID project had some criticism about the methods used, it was the only global assessment available to scientists, decision makers, and land managers to date. Land Degradation Assessment in Drylands, LADA. The LADA approach was developed based on the assumption that human activities on the land are the main drivers causing land degradation. Therefore, defining and mapping of different land use systems are very crucial activities for underpinning the assessment and its implementation. The entire LADA approach gives consideration to the relationships between the causes and effects that lead to degradation. The LADA project operates by using a variety of technologies, from satellite images to digital databases, to soil and vegetation sampling, and the examination of the linkages between both biophysical and socioeconomic issues. Global assessment efforts list net primary productivity, NPP, rainfall use efficiency, RUE, aridity index, AI, rainfall variability, RV, and erosion risk, ER, as the leading indicators of land degradation. The Global Land Degradation Assessment, GLADA, was the global component of LADA. GLADA aims at providing a baseline for the assessment of global trends in land degradation using a range of scale-appropriate indicators, many of which are collected through satellite sensors and processing satellite data and existing global databases. Remote sensing is a tool for land degradation and desertification assessments. Methods for monitoring current state and changes of landscapes use the advantages and potential of satellite-borne or airborne remote sensing imagery. Most work has focused on identifying the change and detection of decreases in land cover rather than identifying the inverse process. Considerable amount of studies explore the capabilities of remote sensing on different monitoring applications and different remote sensing approaches and data. Remote sensing applications can be summarized mainly in four categories that include cover classification, estimation of structures, change detection, and modeling. Remote sensing has the potential to be decidedly instrumental in the assessment of degradation processes at a much lower cost than any other method. Assessment, i.e. measurement, and monitoring through remote sensing offer a series of advantages such as consistency of data, fairly near real-time reporting, and a source for having spatially explicit data. Although there are several approaches to describe land cover changes using remote sensing technology, forest inventory and limited sampling of degradation on the ground are fundamental to its quantification. The methods used are unique to each location and strongly dependent on how its components are clearly identified and responsive to accurate measurement, and how country requirements apply to these methods. Remote sensing is a suitable tool for the estimation of biomass for large areas, usually at regional or national scales, where field data are scarce. There is an abundance of literature that describes the virtues and capabilities of remote sensing-based methods for forest monitoring assessments. The continuing advances in remote sensing science and technology and the enormous amount of data these platforms and sensors produce daily provide a promising foundation to underpin any degradation monitoring program. The possibility of integration of optical and multispectral remote sensing data to active sensors such as LIDAR, light detection and ranging, and radar, radio detection and ranging, combined with ground data, has gained a significant relevance and a high potential for contributing to the design of degradation assessment and monitoring methodologies. Direct detection of degradation processes, for example in forest landscapes, relates area changes to, and focuses on, forest canopy damage. These changes in forest attributes occurring during a period of time can be detected using information from Natural Forest Resources Inventories, FRI, and some from remote sensing. Medium spatial resolution satellite remote sensing data such as Landsat Thematic Mapper, TM, and SPOT have proven capable of obtaining regional scale forest variables. Indirect approaches focus on the spatial distribution and the effects that the evolution of human infrastructure has had on the degradation of nearby areas. Often, these indirect factors are used as proxies for newly degraded areas.